If we want to execute construction of buildings like residential, commercial, industrial, or institutional, the building type may be anyone, but the reading and understanding of drawings very important in case of execution. My question is, do you know how to read drawings? If not, watch this video from starting to ending. So why wait? Let's start. Hello friends, welcome to Center for Civil Engineers. In this video, I am going to give you a list of drawings. Here you can see the list. First one is architectural drawing, second one is structural drawing, third one is electrical, fourth one is plumbing, fifth one is firefighting. If you want to finish any project, these are the common types of drawings. Today I am going to talk about this architectural drawing. Let me show you the architecture plan. See, here you can see the plot size. The width of the plot is 30 feet and the length of the plot is 60 feet. Here you can see size of the plot. This we have to read 30 feet by 60 feet, equivalent to 1800 square feet and also equivalent to 200 square yards. See, the architectural drawing nothing but the drawing which shows you room dimensions and position of furniture and position of doors, windows, ventilators and staircase position. This is about the architecture drawing. But for today's class, I have taken simple drawing that I will show you. Before that, let me explain about, there are two types of buildings. First one is load bearing structure building and frame structure. The first picture shows you load bearing structure. Load bearing structure nothing but old type of structures. The building which carries all loads through the walls and foundation and to the ground. That is called load bearing structure. Whereas in second one, in second case, this is called frame structure. In frame structure, all loads carried by the slabs, columns, beams and footing and then soil. Like this, load transfer will be there in case of frame structure. Nowadays, popularly used structure is this frame structure. Then drawings. Now here you can see four drawings. First one is plan, bottom one is plan, second one is elevation, third one is section, fourth one is site plan. I'll explain one by one. Here you can see plan of a building. This plan is drawn by using mini drafter and protractors. See, from the main door, I am going to explain. This D stands for door and these are the two steps. In plan, you can see only treads. Two treads are there. This is the main door. Now coming to living room. Living room size is 3.11 by 3.43. We have to read 3.11 by 3.43. And 3.11 nothing but from this corner of the room to this corner. And 3.43 nothing but this corner to this corner. That is the meaning of these dimensions in all rooms. See, next here W is written. W, wherever W is there, that is window, and wherever V is written, that is ventilator. This ventilator you can see in only kitchen. Okay, in the plan you can see only room dimensions and door positions, window positions. These two are just openings. There is no shutter here, just opening, opening from this room to this room. In front side you can see staircase. This type of staircase is called dog-legged staircase. There are two flights, flight 1 and flight 2. Here in front of main door we have portico. This is the size of the portico, 3.34 by 1.50 meter. Okay, this is about the plan. Let me explain about the front elevation. Here you can see the front elevation. Front elevation nothing but the view which we can see from front side of the building. See, this is up to here, this is basement. Up to here, this is basement. This is the ground level. Here it is not mentioned. Ground level we have to mention like this. Three lines in 45 degrees angle. If you draw three lines like this, that is ground level. Here, this is ground level. Here you can see the steps. This is the door, main door. This type of door is called panel door. Panel door generally made by using wood. Above this door there is a sunshade here. This is called sunshade, and this also, this projection of left side, this is called also sunshade. The purpose of sunshade is to prevent entering of rain into the room and also to prevent from entering of sun rays. Next, this is parapet. This is the parapet. The purpose of parapet is to prevent from falling. Next, here you can see the first flight, and this is landing, and this is second flight up. This is another sunshade is there. This is also sunshade. Here we have one more window. This is the window. This also made by wood. This is also called panel window. This is about the elevation. Here you can see section diagram. Section gives you complete details of wall thickness and thickness of PCC bed and thickness of sand filling and height of first footing and second footing and PCC bed, bottom PCC bed, and it gives you overall depth of the foundation. Generally, while digging the foundation is going to dig like this. The width of foundation is 0.9 meter and depth of foundation is this total 0.3 plus 0.3 plus 0.3, that means 0.9 meter. Okay. After digging the foundation, next we have to construct first PCC bed, next first footing and second footing. Then up to this is called substructure, this is ground level, and above again the wall is going to construct from this level, ground level. Okay, this wall thickness is 9-inch wall thickness. External walls are constructed using 9-inch wall thickness. Here you can see steps here, and here this is lintel cum sunshade. This portion is called lintel and this is called sunshade, and above we have this masonry, and here you have the total height of this parapet wall. Here you can see the text. This is the thickness of parapet wall and thickness of RCC slab and RCC sunshade, and the projection of sunshade is 0.6 meter, and this is flooring. Flooring is done by using cement concrete of thick 150 mm thick, and this is the total depth of the basement. And here you can see the first footing is constructed by using brick masonry, and this is CC bed proportion is 1:4:8. Like this, complete details will be given in the section diagram. In this diagram only we'll be able to know all thicknesses of elements. Next one, site plan. Here you can see site plan. This is width of the plot, this is length of the plot, and the center shaded area nothing but built up area of this building. By using this 7.23 multiplied by 6.33 gives you built up area of this building, and these dimensions, this one and this one, all these are setbacks. These setbacks dimensions depends upon locality of the building. For example, JHMC limits, municipality limits and Gram Panchayat limits, depends upon locality will be having separate dimensions. All these dimensions are very important while preparing the drawing to get the approval from the municipal authorities. See here, front side you can see the sign. This sign is called continuity sign. This indicates further road is there. Here also further road is there. Here you can see width of the road, 7.3 meter wide, nothing but width of this road, and this is the main gate sign. Like this, complete information of land and neighboring lands will be given in the site plan. Okay, here you can see plot numbers of left side and right side and back side. I hope all these drawings are useful to you, and if you have any doubts regarding all these drawings, you can ask in comment section. You can also join in Telegram group. I have given link in description, and also I have given links of all social media networks You can find links and you can follow me. Don't be like strangers. Subscribe and watch. Thank you for watching this video.